the blue corner. He is a former one flyweight world champion, standing at 172 centimeters tall, holding a mixed martial arts record of 17 wins and 3 losses. Training out of American Top Team and Constrictor Team, representing Brazil, presenting to you the challenger, Adriano. Introducing his opponent out of the red corner. He is a wushu and sanda artist, standing at 163 centimeters tall, holding a wushu record of 38 wins and 2 losses. Training out of Team Lakai, representing the Philippines. Give it up for your reigning and defending one flyweight world champion, Geje Eustaquio.
Watch out for headbutt, low blow, back of the head and spine. I want a clear, fair fight. 5 rounds, touch gloves. Back your corner.
Champion Eustaquio. Eustaquio wants to keep it standing, employ his championship wushu striking skills. Moraes, multi-time BJJ world champion, wants to take it down. Fake there from Moraes. Both men just dipping their toes in the proverbial water here, Dragon.
They're both looking very light on their feet, just kind of feeling each other out. This is essentially round 11 between the two. Actually, no, round 8. Sorry. First one didn't go the distance.
Jab there from Eustaquio. It's been a while between drinks. This the first trilogy match in one championship history. Both men know each other so well. Both have tremendous respect for each other's talents.
See this, I don't like seeing this from Geje. Geje's letting Moraes back him up into the corner. And the last time we saw Geje get backed up in the corner, he was competing at bantamweight, and it was against Tony Taru. Tony Taru just backed him up against the corner, took him down, and choked him out. Like it when Geje starts moving, when he gets circles out from the cage, he's sticking and moving, light on his feet, not standing statically still in front of Moraes.
Good counter overhand right there from Geje Eustaquio. Champion telling us yesterday, I've got the power to knock Moquinho out. Moraes telling us, I'll be like a spider, just wait for Eustaquio to get caught in my web and I'll tap him out. You know that Demetrius Johnson is watching this one. He'll have to go through the flyweight Grand Prix to get a crack at the eventual champion. Whether it's Moraes, whether it's Eustaquio, the moment still a filling out process here, Mitch.
Moraes traveled to the United States to compete in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu contests. He won the New York Open, and he also won the Naga in the black belt division during his break, so he was definitely sharpening those skills, but here his hands are looking pretty sharp.
Moraes has the reach over Eustaquio, the leg reach and the arm reach. As the speed, the pepper here at the moment, Eustaquio trying to get on the inside. Outside leg kick from Moraes. 5-time world champion Moraes, 2-time world champion Eustaquio. He had more than 110 martial arts world champions here at one championship.
Good front put, rear push kick from Geje. He was able to split the guard.
Inside leg kick from Eustaquio, pumps out the jab. Stuck on that side of the cage, Geje, right in front of the Team Lakai corner. Edward Flying, Mark Sangao, giving the instructions to the champion. Pump kick there from Moraes. Edging towards center cage now, both these men. Kick start. He's warming up. Kick there from Eustaquio. House kick for the lower right rib cage in Moraes. Skip up inside, full extension of the lead hand there from Eustaquio.
Moraes says he wants to be more aggressive in this, but we're not quite seeing it. We're just kind of trading these pitter-pat shots right now. Moraes hasn't even attempted a takedown yet. He's content to just keep this on the feet and trade shots with Geje.
A glorified kickboxing contest at the moment. Eustaquio,
1 minute.
Chuck looking through his brow. Slightly lower hands on Moraes. The more jittery of the two. Plenty of movement from Moraes. A little bit more planting of the feet from Geje Eustaquio. Certainly the more flat footed of the two. Fake there from Moraes. Eustaquio just probing with the lead hand, trying to get his distance. Throws the right hand as Moraes came in. Jab to inside thigh kick, jab again from the champion.
I expect this. In the first round, Moraes is going to attempt a takedown here in the next couple, I would say next 20 seconds or so.
Most people I spoke to this week, most of the experts, believed this one would also go the distance. Now set for 5 rounds. Moraes, the more confident of the two, finishing. Eustaquio said, I can knock Moraes out, but I believe I will win by decision. End of the first round, we go to the towels.
Interesting, I was wrong. Not even a takedown attempt in the first 5 minutes from Adriano Moraes.
Look at the scene here inside the Mall of Asia Arena. Sellouts in this massive arena. They've all turned out for Geje Eustaquio. Can he take care of business against this man, Adriano Moraes?
You can just see the mutual respect shown in those first 5 minutes. They were just feeling each other out, seeing if anybody brought anything new to the table. Geje says that Moraes is a one-trick pony. All he's going to do is throw those hands, maybe a couple of kicks, shoot, and try to take me down. Moraes knows what Geje wants to do. He knows that Lakai-style striking. He's been up against multiple Lakai athletes. So it'll be interesting to see if anybody's game plan changes. Both of these guys need to shift up a little bit and start putting a little bit more aggression behind themselves, because right now, dead even.
Back.
Moraes first to emerge off his stool. Here we go, second round set for 5 for the World Flyweight Championship.
Ready?
2-time world champion Eustaquio, the 5-time world champion Moraes. Philippines versus Brazil. Silence in the Mall of Asia Arena. They are waiting to erupt should Geje Eustaquio land his wushu strikes, Mitch.
You can see him just waiting for that opening. Geje's letting Moraes walk forward. Geje's typically a counter striker. He's got a beautiful left hook, but there's the first takedown of the match. Beautifully timed. He found his moment. Led Geje to believe that he was going to strike with him. Slid underneath for that double leg.
Defense.
This is where Moraes excels. He didn't have that same opportunity to utilize the cage when they competed in the ring last time. Now Moraes has the opportunity, but he is turning him away from the cage, so Geje is not able to use the cage to walk back up.
Fantastic look at the half guard position, trying to pry that leg open there, Adriano Moraes. Eustaquio having to work off his back. Not the preferred position for Eustaquio. He said to us yesterday, I'm unfazed by any of the ground game of Moraes.
Watch out, back of the head.
He's taken Moraes' best submission attempt in 2 matches so far.
Beautiful job by Geje to dig with the underhooks, scoot onto his side.
Oh, punch the back, there's Moraes. Gonna take him for a ride. That's Moraes against the cage. Here comes the right hand from the challenger. Scooping in the uppercuts. Right in the back of Geje Eustaquio.
Geje's got to be careful in this position. Watch, Adriano Moraes is going to slowly start to adjust his position. He's a little bit too far on the right side. So Geje has got to try to, first he's got to break that grip. See how Adriano Moraes has his legs triangled and one leg is laced underneath there? It's going to help him secure this position. It's hard to finish when your opponent is standing up like this. It's hard, but it also takes a lot of leg strength as well.
Illegal blow to the back of the head with the elbow. A warning there from referee Olivier Cox. Still on the back. Is this more training on Moraes or more training on Eustaquio?
Well, I would assume the years of experience that Moraes has, he's going to be fine in a lot of these positions. He's very, he has stamina. And he goes underneath him and taking the arm. So his arm is in danger. Now his leg is in danger. Moraes looking for a knee bar.
Geje takes Moraes back. Have a look at this.
step through this. Geje Eustaquio does it better than most. Beautiful, look at this, how he turns in. He's able to end up on top from a bad position to a good one. Very impressive.
Third round of five.
Yes, back.
Geje Eustaquio, the two-time and defending flyweight world champion. Also a Philippine national wushu champion. Adriano Moraes, the five-time one flyweight world champion. And also a multiple BJJ world champ. What a back and forth contest. A brilliant second stanza. Nice, low sweeping leg kick there from Eustaquio. So relaxed, so fluid, the champion, and he's striking. Resets again here. Oh, nicely done. Jump balking right hand there from Eustaquio. And hands cocked and ready. Can he sucker Moraes in? Is the high kick. Jab doubles up with the lead hand as Eustaquio.
Geje's okay to get pushed up against the cage like that. Almost rope-a-dope, actually, trying to wait for Moraes to expend some energy so he can come back and counter.
Good outside low kick, triple turn. Beating Moraes to the punch here. Moraes may be starting to get a little frustrated by the strikes landing. Goes to the outside lead side as the challenger. Know that Eustaquio will not tire. If there's one thing that Team Lakai has, it's cardio for days. Training up in those extreme altitudes of Baguio City. Nice to counter off the low kick to Geje Eustaquio.
What's the altitude out there, Michael Spello?
I think it's around 6,000 feet.
You said it last week. It was just under 5,000 feet of elevation.
Did you ask me that? Can you or
I was checking.
Still a striking contest here in the third of five. Good outside leg kick from Eustaquio. Just dropping it on top of the lead knee of Moraes. Body shot to the sternum. Moraes has got to get some strikes off of his own now. From Eustaquio. Moraes telling us yesterday, Mitch, I don't want this to go to a decision in Manila. And he needs to do a whole lot more. He needs to start getting it closer. Look for a way to get the champion on his back.
Because right now, Geje is letting go of some serious hand combinations. He's countering Moraes' attacks very well, especially on that hook. You can see a little bit of damage that Geje's wearing a little bit, but it's not affecting him too much. Moraes has got to turn this up. He's got to start putting Geje onto his back, creating those scrambles, dominate from the top position. He's not winning the striking exchanges here.
Hello to another world champion here at One who is watching live, the great Bibiano Fernandez. He's cheering on his compatriot, Adriano Moraes. Roundhouse kick there from Eustaquio. Single leg lockup from Moraes. What can he do with it here, the Brazilian?
You see him transition to a double. Turn the corner and then go after the double. Ah, but Geje was able to maintain that balance and keep it on his feet.
Jab to body shot from Eustaquio. It's been a bread and butter combination for the Filipino. Skip up front kick from him. High right round kick. Eustaquio loves up high. Throws the uppercut. Almost takes out a ring light. Back to center cage for Moraes. Eustaquio goes to the body, both sides of the carcass. Skips forward now the champion. Backing up Moraes momentarily. Front kick, Moraes swings wildly with a looping left hand. Roundhouse kick, found the elbow. It can be painful if you land a kick to an opponent's elbow. It'll hurt your instep, the top of your foot. Gotta be careful. Outside leg kick from Eustaquio. 1 minute five remaining, Mitch, third of five.
Moraes gonna have to do something here. Extremely impressive to inch this round his way, because right now, Eustaquio is counter-striking brilliantly.
Eustaquio a little frustrated with himself. Checks the low kick. Moraes, full extension on the jab.
The jab looked nice.
And again, time to bring the right hand over the top of Eustaquio's left shoulder. Little cut on the bridge of the nose, it looks like. The champion. Under 30 seconds remains now. This entire round has mostly been a striking contest. Gives the lead hand down the body, does Eustaquio, gets out of the way of the high left roundhouse. They're going to go down to the towels at the end of three.
That's it, good.
Overhand right, left hook, nothing connecting. More to the uppercut from Eustaquio. We are moving in to deep water. Everybody in the sold-out Mall of Asia Arena. We had to turn back a lot of people at the door tonight. Unfortunately, this huge arena can only hold so many, and it is packed out. Mitch, how do you see it?
Interesting third round. We saw a lot of scrambles. The first round was kind of null. The second round was a lot of grappling, a lot of scrambles. Very entertaining second round. The third round, a little bit more back and forth action, but we saw the counter striking of Geje start to do more damage, start touching up Adriano. But Adriano was able to find that jab. He was able to utilize the jab to start piecing up Geje. So it's interesting to now to get into those championship rounds. Now we're into deep water. How are these guys going to move forward? Because right now it's pretty close.
We move in to the business end of this world title match. Geje Eustaquio, two-time world champion. Adriano Moraes, a five-time world champion. As I look at the trends on Philippines Twitter at the moment, interestingly, Moraes is trending on Twitter here in the Philippines. Skip up roundhouse kick from the challenger. Moraes for the loss to Eustaquio last time. And one four on the trot, including over Eugene Takiro, Tilik Batyarov, Karen Akhmatov, and the King, Danny Kingad, tapping up the King in only the first round with a rear naked choke. Has fared well against Filipinos, Adriano Moraes. Pick up the pace here against Geje Eustaquio. Eustaquio is such an unassuming world champion. A real rocky story here at ONE Championship. Quiet spoken, mild mannered. He can be ferocious inside the cage.
He's so humble. He's got a little bit of cockiness to him now. He's putting on that swagger of being the world champion, and with good reason. He's starting to put together some good combinations in this fourth round. Adriano's starting to push forward and do some work on his own, though.
A short left hand there. Mitch, when you know your opponent so well, when you've competed against each other so many times before, how do you change it up here? How do you change levels, change directions to do something the other doesn't expect?
You think that, you know, Adriano would try to take this more to his strength. He seems content to sit here and exchange shots in the fourth round where he might be in behind in some of the scorecards.
So in what we're seeing, which is a striking battle predominantly, do you think Geje is having the upper hand?
He's connecting a little bit more on the counter shots. He is countering a little bit more effectively. We're starting to see, you know, Adriano is the one moving forward. He's showing the aggression, but I think Geje is landing with a little bit more emphasis.
Elbow there from Eustaquio came agonizingly close to shaving off the eyebrow. The body shot there from Moraes returns the favorite as the champion. Fakes downstairs, goes upstairs. Lead left hook from Eustaquio doesn't connect, and the Wushu champion. Sets himself, nice skip up inside leg kick. And again, he's in that central profunda.
I like when Geje's moving forward. He's starting to show aggression, because when he's allowing Adriano to dictate it, oh, but a nice duck under, takes the back.
Oh, this is more like it. This is Moraes' world. This is Adrianoville. He's got the back of the champion, and he's going for a ride again. What can Eustaquio do from here, Dragon?
Well, he's trying to shake him off the backside, but he chooses to stand back up. You can see, watch, Adriano's gonna triangle his legs together, snake one leg underneath the legs there. Now we're back to where we were in the beginning of the second round.
Moraes said he'd be like a spider. Is Eustaquio stuck in the web here? It looks like a demented game of Twister. A submission attempt from Adriano Moraes. Referee Olivia goes right on top of the action. Have a look at this.
Oh.
Oh, my word. Have a look at this.
The body is not supposed to bend that way.
What pain may Eustaquio be in? His face isn't showing it. The flexibility of the champion. I've never seen this before. How do you get out of it? A spider's web. This is amazing. Have a look at this sub attempt. What do you call it there?
Look at him, he's trying to knee bar. That's basically a rear naked knee bar, I think is what he's trying to do. He's got that leg triangled around the body. Geje's got to try to release that triangled leg. So he's got to try to release the right leg of Adriano. Adriano's trying to crank on that leg. It's almost near a banana split if he takes the other leg and breaks that right leg over there. But man,
I don't want to know what's the split. All I know is this is awesome. This is crazy. It's a mess of legs and arms, but now Eustaquio's free. But what effect did it take on the champion's left leg? You've got to wonder on the hamstring, on the knee, on the gastrocnemius muscle. What effect did it take on Geje Eustaquio?
Gastrocnemius is the calf muscle for all the people out there. But that was an interesting submission move. But look at Geje getting him on top.
Have a look at this. Back onto his feet.
Oh, look at the leg.
Going nuts again.
The leg almost came back.
Is called fifth and final round, the championship round.
I think we need to call it the Moraes Mangler, because
Again, very ginger on that left leg is Geje Eustaquio.
Moraes should go right after that leg and just start laying into the leg kicks.
I agree. Just kick it all night long now. Let's see how it holds up for the champion. Moraes comes out jabbing. There's the right idea to that common peroneal move just above the lead knee.
Now, was that close to a near submission? You gotta believe it was. Geje gave the thumbs up, but
it looked to me at one stage like his hamstring.
So instead of keeping Geje on his feet, Moraes may want to take him down. You know, he's not gonna be able to scramble the same way. He's not gonna be able to move the same on the ground. Start laying into leg kicks. Don't stand there and box with him.
This crowd, this sellout crowd in Manila, expectant of the champion. 1 minute down in the final round, four to go. We are scoring on an overall contest, not round by round. Jab two, then a hook from the champion, Eustaquio. Jab two again down the center corridor, then goes to the outside leg, throws the right hand lead. Looking for a takedown, gets a takedown to Moraes. Now let's see the survival skills. Let's see the defense from Eustaquio. He's back to his feet!
Interesting how Geje is able to try to, he kind of shrimps out or hip escapes out. And it's like he's going for a kimura on the side, but he utilizes that hip position to create that scramble and to get up.
Geje glances up at the big screen. Tries to thread the left hand over the top. 3 minutes, 10 remaining. Moraes backs off. They reset center cage. Jab two again from Eustaquio. Checks the low kick. There's the champion. The two-time world champion, Eustaquio. The five-time world champion, Moraes. And he drives Eustaquio onto the canvas. Top position for the challenger, Moraes.
Nice double leg there for Moraes. Now he's got to be careful because watch, Geje, if he gets back into half guard, he's going to try that same awkward sit-up. See how he tries to overhook the head and then move his body out to the side. And there he creates a little bit of movement, but he doesn't do it well in half guard. He doesn't do it well in full guard. He does it well in half guard position. So he keeps trying to do that, overhook the head and then create space on that one side. See, he does it. So he overhooks the head and then he starts to hip escape out. In half guard it works very well, but not so well in full guard. Adriano's got to catch on to that and keep him in this position. He might try to advance and step over, and Geje might let him go in just so he can get out again.
2 minutes remaining to the fifth and final round. Still has Moraes inside the guard, closes the guard now. Looking for the elbow into this. Collarbone of the challenger. Elbow from Moraes. A chance go up. Geje. Oh, a nice push off from the champion. Look out for the up kicks here. Moraes has got to be careful. Those heels flying towards his door. Is he going to allow Eustaquio back to his feet? No, he won't. Goes inside the guard.
Smart move on Moraes' part. You can see Geje is trying to overhook the head, trying to hip escape out.
Under a minute remaining. Who's going to dig deep? Who's going to go into the well? The intestinal fortitude. Who's got the gusto? Who's got the pepper? Who's got the fuel in the tank to bring it home to capture flyweight gold? And look, he's back here, Eustaquio. And down goes Moraes again, inside the Filipino's guard.
Moraes is in half guard, so look for two. Look, escape out and create that scramble. Moraes has got to apply a lot of top pressure, not allow Geje to create that little bit of space.
This has been an amazing world title bout. It has been one to remember. The first ever trilogy match in one championship history. Moraes in half guard. Is he going to finish the contest here? Both men trying the body shots. We're going down the judges in Manila. We had
Look at Geje slipping through the guard, letting the 1-2 go. But then Adriano Moraes does what he does, slides under the punch combination, secures
your winner by unanimous decision and new.